Well, we all want healthy, beautiful, radiant skin, and sometimes the secret to glowing skin actually starts at a really young age. I'm here with Jamie Cole, and she is the owner of Skin Deep Laser Spa right here in Strongsville. Hello, Jamie.
Hello, Nicole. Thank you for coming in to meet with us.
I'm so happy to be talking with you today because this is a topic that has been really popular around a lot of kitchen tables and in car rides. We're talking about skincare, particularly for young women and young men.
Yes, it is extraordinary. We are hearing more and more that kids are opting to go to these specialty skincare stores more than they want to go to Disney. There is a growing interest among young people starting at age 10.
Wow, so we're talking teens and tweens, and it's funny, you know, when I was that age, I was excited about my Lip Smackers purchase. I'm sure you were too.
I was too.
And now, I was just recently in a very well-known beauty store, and I could not believe the amount of teenagers that were there looking at products that I was interested in.
Spending hundreds of dollars on products that really aren't helping their skin, it's actually hurting their skin. There's a lot of misinformation out there, and that's where we come in. We are hoping that parents and kids alike will understand that we are a resource for them.
For people that have young children or even grandparents that maybe want to take their grandchildren to get them onto a routine that is good for them, mm-hmm. is such a big deal. Instead of having those children look at TikTok and social media thinking, oh, I need this, I need that, I need this.
Absolutely. It's wonderful that kids are wanting to take care of themselves, right? This is a beautiful trend, but we want to give them the right things to be using. Cleansing, hydrating, sunscreen, all super important. But products beyond that, are they really helping? We don't think so. And so I think that's where hopefully we can add that level of expertise for parents and kids to point them in a really positive, healthier direction.
All right, so there are a lot of different things that I've heard you should do, things that I've heard you shouldn't do. I think we need to meet with Melody now, who is one of your estheticians, so she can break those myths and confirm or deny all the things that we're hearing. Sound good?
Completely agree. Sounds great.
Let's do it.
Okay.
Okay, so first up, we're gonna figure out fact or fiction. Number one, are tweens and teens supposed to be using products that contain retinol and peptides and acids?
Absolutely not. Their skin is just already exfoliating naturally at a rapid pace, and they already have collagen production that's really high. And retinol is what they do. They're going to promote collagen production and also exfoliate the skin. So they just don't need it. And over time, if they were to use it, it actually would damage their barrier. So it'd be like an adverse reaction for them. So down the line, their skin would be more sensitive. They would have more redness to the skin. So overall, it just would not be the best choice for their age. It would actually be 20 years and up.
No way.
Yeah.
Okay, so don't do that.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Number two, is it good even at a younger age for the teenagers and the tweens to come up with a skincare routine?
Yeah, they can have a skincare routine, but it's just going to be simple, which is kind of tough nowadays just because a lot of teens and tweens are seeing things on social media, mm-hmm. like TikTok and things like that, and running to the stores and buying like the first aesthetically pleasing packaged product. But really all they need is a gentle cleanser morning and night, also something that's hydrating if their skin's a little bit drier, and an SPF for protection.
Do they need a toner?
No, not necessarily, okay. But if it was something that was a little bit more calming, mm-hmm. it wouldn't hurt.
Okay, all right, mm-hmm. and then number three, something that a lot of teens and tweens deal with, acne. So what are some of the ways that they can get rid of the acne, and do they need strong medications for it?
Right. I mean, if they were considering something to treat their acne, I wouldn't say just run to the dermatologist and get on a prescription. I would actually say, you know, come in office, let me look at your skin, let me try a facial and see how their skin responds from there. Because for some of them, it could just be that their pH balance in their skin is unbalanced, where they're too oily, too dry. So by doing a monthly facial and incorporating more medical grade products that helps to balance out the pH, you'll notice that maybe some of their acne will start to clear up for them.
Well, mm-hmm. I learned so much. And this just goes to show you some of the stuff that you hear on social media, it is not true. Mm-hmm. So go to the professionals. Melody, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And thanks to Jamie, who we spoke with earlier. If you want more information, you can log onto their website at skindeeplaserspa.com.